morning, guys. Welcome back for another vlog. I did one of these recently, but I just feel like I offloaded to you guys and I don't really like that. And I kind of was thinking, well, if people watch my vlogs to kind of escape for a bit, then they probably don't want to hear about my life dramas. So we're gonna just excuse all that for this week. I'm gonna do a weekly vlog. I have actually quite like a busy kind of fun week coming up, so I thought it was the perfect time to pick up the camera. Obviously I can keep you guys posted with just like some chatty sections along the way. Made myself a coffee. I have so much admin work to do today. It's actually not even funny. Like, I have so many emails to get back to. That's what I need to do today. So it's probably gonna be a little bit of a boring day for the vlog, I'm not gonna lie. I might cook dinner with you guys tonight because I miss doing that. I've done so many vlogs where I then like cook with you in the evenings. Obviously you guys know that I do HelloFresh and I've used HelloFresh for literally years. They are actually very kindly sponsoring today's video. Later on this week, I've got brunch with one of my friends on Wednesday, which will be super nice. Thursday, randomly, I'm going to see GLS with Aisha and Zal. Kind of out of the blue, kind of random. Honestly, I think I know about 3 songs, so I need to like put their albums on repeat to try and learn something, so I'm not just stood in the crowd like, hey, like I don't know any of the words. But I'm actually really looking forward to that because I think it would be so nice to just spend some time with the girls anyway. So I've got that on Thursday, and then also on Tuesday, I think Zal was babysitting Mila, so I was like, I'll come and help because I just, I love that baby so much. Like, I'm so excited to see her again. So I'm gonna go over to Zal and Ben's on Tuesday and see them and help them babysit. And then I feel like I've got something going on Friday, but I literally can't remember. And then the weekend, again, I think I've got plans, but I can't remember what they are. So we'll see as the vlog unfolds. But like I say, HelloFresh are very kindly sponsoring today's video. Sorry, my phone keeps going off, but like there's no notifications. I'm very confused. Maybe it's a ghost texting me. It was Halloween last night. Didn't do anything for Halloween this year, which is kind of sad. Like, I was literally sat at home like watching everyone's stories like, oh my god, I wish I was dressed up like a dead Barbie and like going out, but I wasn't. I was watching a kid's film at Brad's parents' house. I feel like me and Brad literally miss Halloween every single year. Like, last year we were in Antigua. So, like I say, you guys will know that I have used them for years. They are just the best subscription service. Like, if you are really busy, if you work like a 9-to-5 job, like 5 days a week, and you kind of get home and you don't really want to think about what you need to make for dinner, or you don't want to go to shops to get stuff in, then HelloFresh is the best thing to go for. Everything is delivered to your door. You can choose all of your meals. You can decide how frequently you want your boxes. You can decide how many people you want your boxes for. You can skip weeks. So if you're away for 1 week, which is obviously perfect for me because sometimes I'll just randomly be in London for an entire week. And if I know that's going to happen, then I can literally just go on my app, press edit delivery and skip that week. If you guys are interested in checking them out, then I will leave a link down below in the description. Sign up through that link, then you will get a discount. Very thankful that they are sponsoring this video. It just feels so fitting because I have raved about them for so long on my channel, and I love that I now get to work with them. It's just amazing. So I'll cook my dinner with you guys tonight so you can kind of get an idea of what some of the meals are, and I'll kind of talk you through like the other meal cards that we have. There literally is something for everyone. They also do have a new feature that I've seen recently where they have like dinner to lunch kind of meals, so they almost send you a few more ingredients at the smallest extra cost, and you can make your dinner the night before and then you will always have enough left over for like lunch the next day. So again, if you're super busy and you just want to take something into the office, then that will also be perfect. They also have brunch menus and little extras that you can add, like focaccias and little goo desserts, which are personally my favorite. I get them every single week. So yeah, there's just lots of options on there. And like I say, I will leave a link down below if you do want to go and check it out. But let's get on with the rest of the day. I will update you guys, I'm sure, throughout the day. But just imagine me like sat like this on my laptop. That's what I'm going to be doing. So I just don't think it's that interesting. Also, grab yourself a cup of tea or a cup of coffee or a hot chocolate or a glass of wine, whatever you fancy. I don't know what time you're watching this, but it's currently 9:55 in the morning. So glass of wine seems a little bit of a push for me right now. But yeah, just grab yourself a drink and maybe some snacks because I do feel like this is going to be a long one. Kind of loving the long vlogs lately, I'm not going to lie. Like, it's getting cold in the evenings, getting dark pretty quickly. So I just love to stick one of these on in the evening and just completely chill out. So I hope you can do that to today's vlog. Like I say, it's gonna be very lighthearted. There's gonna be no dramas here. We're not bringing anyone's mood down today, so enjoy.
This is my little work setup for the morning. I have quite possibly the coziest Zara home blanket ever. Not gonna lie, it does kind of molt, but it's worth it because it's literally so soft and I love it. And I am currently on Princess Polly because I am actually working with them again, but I'm gonna go for like all of their winter autumn stuff and do like a proper wintry haul so we're ready for the next season because it's freezing in the UK right now. Got my coffee, and then I'm also going to finish off watching Adina's vlog from the Beauty Works event. If you guys don't follow Adina, then you are missing out. So nice to see her there. I've literally not seen her for ages, but yeah, if you don't follow her, go and follow her. I'm gonna leave her Instagram and her YouTube channel linked down below, but I love her vlogs so much.
Don't worry, her vlogs are coming. But
I don't think we got enough time to sort out all the fights, yeah. Sort out all the lies. Oh baby, yeah. There was a part of me that knew that, and still I'm caught by surprise. I thought you'd always be mine. Oh, yeah. I guess our dreams fell asleep. There's no passion in the comatose. Baby, going down, down, down.
My God. It is 6 o'clock, 10 past 6. I honestly, when I say I have spent all day looking through that Zara website, I'm not exaggerating. I'm not feeling it at the moment. I don't know what it is. I just feel like they don't have the best stuff in. And I feel like I'm just missing something because usually I absolutely love Zara, especially at this time of year. But I just really wasn't feeling it. I did manage to find, I say that I managed to find like 15 items. So there will be a haul coming very soon, which I am still quite excited about. Because I think I'm basically going to like, I just feel like everything I got was quite basic. So I think I'm just going to style everything up in outfits and kind of do the haul that way, if that makes sense. But I'm hungry. I thought I would come in here and start making some dinner. This is what we had delivered to our door this morning. Oh God. So this is our HelloFresh box, which obviously we get anyway. Fun fact, when you are working with HelloFresh, they do tend to send you a box like complimentary for free for the job to do. This just came anyway, and I kind of like, I was like, don't worry, I'll just use my own box. So this is what arrived this morning. So I'm gonna start by putting all of this stuff away, but I thought I'd quickly run you through the recipe cards that we have.
These pork and black bean tacos are one of my favorite meals. Very simple, it literally takes like 20 minutes. They have these kind of like rapid meals, which are obviously really good, again, if you're busy and on the go all the time. And then we have chili cheese, smoky sausage on brioche buns, basically like fancy hot dogs. That is a really good meal as well. Pork gnocchi. So far every single thing is pork. That was not intentional, but I just thought all these meals look really good. And then we have an extra large honey and bacon cheeseburger, which also looks really good. So yeah, they obviously have 30 odd recipes like I've already said to you guys, but these are just the ones that I went for this week.
I think I'm gonna make this, which is the pork gnocchi. Yeah, I've had this recipe before and it's actually really good. And again, this one is like super quick. Apparently it takes 25 minutes to make, so I'm gonna go with that. Also, same old thing, same old situation about the kitchen. There's a load of mess, I know. I think we are gonna kind of change our plans when it comes to this house, which probably sounds a bit rogue and I probably need to do like a whole video explaining it, but obviously I mentioned it earlier on in this video. Redecorating or like fitting a new kitchen and things like that, so I need to sit down with you guys and have a little chat, I think, about our thoughts and feelings towards this place at the moment. Like, I still love it and I would absolutely love to make it like our dream home and our dream family home like right now, but it's just not, I don't think that's what we want to put our money in right now. Obviously we've just bought the second house and we want to kind of invest in that. Like, this house is more than livable in, so I think that's why we're just not in a rush to just add like things that are just kind of making it ours, rather than like this, it's nothing that we need to do, if that makes sense. Like, it's not a necessity. We're just in a mindset where we're thinking we want to spend that money doing other things that we want to kind of do in our life and things that we would really love and like have spoken about for literally years. So I think we're gonna make some minor changes. Like, I think we're gonna rip out this kitchen, finally get like a new space that I absolutely love, because I do not love this. I don't feel like I've ever shown you guys in detail this kitchen apart from like when we first moved in, but I mean, this is like what we have to work with. So these just remind me of like working a bar, which is fine. Like obviously, I'm sure a lot of people have these in like pubs and stuff, but this is my home. Like I don't love these at all. We have like the biggest extractor fan for the hob that doesn't even work. Like we have this massive gas hob, which we need to get rid of anyway because our gas bills are a joke. All of these cupboards are like super impractical. Yeah, it's not great, but that's not me complaining. That's just me like kind of trying to explain to you guys how impractical this kitchen is and why that will make me feel so much happier if we do get to rip this out. But anyway, I feel like this weekly vlog is going to be so rambly and I don't want it to be that, so I'm gonna start making this and I will kind of talk you guys through the steps as I do them. Also, this lighting is horrific. So this will have like all of your dry ingredients in it, and then in this bag here is where everything is kind of like kept cool. So there's like ice packs in here. It's got all the meat and like the dairy products and stuff, so that is where the pork mince will be. So I'm just going to get that all out and I will show you guys the ingredients. So we've got parmesan or grated Italian hard cheese, Italian herbs, red wine stock paste, this is Worcester sauce, bag of spinach, obviously the gnocchi, chopped tomatoes, and then the pork mince. And you also get sent a garlic bulb with every single order as well, so every week you'll get a new garlic, because most of the dishes do call for like one or two cloves. So yeah, literally everything you need sent straight to your door is perfect. Okay, so I boiled the gnocchi first and then I'm now just frying it. Not gonna lie, this isn't the best pan because it just sticks all the time, which is kind of annoying. Also, I have made gnocchi before and just fried it, so I think you can do that as well, but that's what's happening over here. And then here we've got the pork mince cooking, and that was all I've done so far. I am catching up on James and Karis. I have just transferred the gnocchi over to the pan with the mince in because, yeah, kind of messed up, but we're just gonna wing it. I've also added the Italian herbs and the Worcester sauce. So now I've added the chopped tomatoes, and then this is the red wine stock, which I also currently have on my finger. We are pretty much there. Tiny pan, but we are making it work. So the final thing I've added in is just the spinach, and I have actually transferred it back to this pan because that was not working. I also completely forgot to put some garlic in. Also, can we talk about the mess that I make when I cook? At least food tastes good, that's all that matters. I forgot to put garlic in, so I just got this very lazy garlic out of the fridge and I just put some of the oil in to kind of give it the flavour. But yeah, I'm just going to let this wilt down and then I'll show you guys the final product.
In the kitchen at all times, this chair often goes at the end of the dining table. It fits in so well. There's some other cool features. Obviously, you've got the straps, 5-point straps, which are very safe.
So that is dinner done. Again, made a complete mess, but this looks and smells amazing. It really didn't take me too long at all. I was not paying attention either, so I did mess up a few steps, like I say, but it looks fine. I've also made myself a gin and tonic. Yes, in a wine glass, but I just feel like this is needed today. I'm just kind of in one of those moods, but oh well. I'm now gonna take this through to the living room and we're gonna catch up on Set's education. But I feel like I'm gonna see you guys in the morning and round this section off just here. Good morning, guys. I have just dropped out at the station. It's 8:45 this morning. I got myself a Starbucks on the way back and it actually made me realize that I think today, obviously now I'm back, I think I'm just gonna go upstairs, get ready, film a video, if not two. I think I wanna film like a favorites video because I haven't done one of those in a while, but I did one like a few months ago, I think, or like literally last year. I personally love watching them. So I think I'm gonna film one of those and then get back in my car, head back to Starbucks and just sit and edit in there. So I'm just kind of like out the house. I haven't edited in a coffee shop for ages and I kind of miss doing that. So I think that's my plan for the day. Again, probably not that exciting for the vlog, but I will of course bring you guys along. I'm just gonna sit here and have my breakfast and then I will go upstairs, get changed, and I'm sure I'll check in with you. I am ready for the day. I'm ready to film my video. I thought I'd just quickly speak you guys through how I do my slick back bun because I always get questions and I definitely need to do a tutorial at some point, but I just feel like it's really simple, but maybe it's just simple because I figured out how to do it. I don't know. So let me know in the comments if you want me to kind of like talk you through this in an upcoming vlog, then I definitely can. But I literally just make sure my hair is damp. So to start with, I'll take like a heat protectant spray or like a leave-in conditioner. The best thing to do it with is actually a hair mask, especially because like I'm on like day 5 hair right now. Like this just could not be styled down, which is why I've gone for a slick back look. So if I'm gonna like wash it anyway, so like tomorrow I'm gonna be washing my hair, so the best thing to do is like put a hair mask in, and then obviously it's being treated as your hair is kind of styled, if that makes sense. Today I couldn't find a hair mask, so I've literally just dampened it with this blowout spray. It can literally be anything, even like water in a spray bottle, it doesn't matter, but it's just so much easier to style when it is damp. And then I'll kind of take like just like a normal brush, like something like this, to detangle it and like get it all scraped back. And then either my tangle teaser brush, excuse the hair, or something like this, like a soft bristled brush. This is the Beautyworks X Molly May one. These are great for slicking your hair back. You can also get like teasing brushes, just anything with like really soft bristles that can really like smooth it all down, if that makes sense. So dampen it, slick it all back into like the tightest ponytail ever. Then I take a load of hairspray and I do like a big spray all over my head, and then I take a softer bristled brush and slick it all down again. Tie up the ponytail with two hairbands, two of like the thick ones. And then I literally just wrap the bun round, tie it, and that's it. And then if you do want to like kind of lay it down a little bit more, then you can just hairspray it again and then go over it with the brush. So yeah, that is how I've done my hair. I am literally just wearing this Boohoo tracksuit. Oh god, there is so much stuff all over this room. I absolutely love this. I love the colour of it. I do wish the hoodie was a little bit more kind of like longer in the sleeves and a bit cosier, but it's fine. It's also got high-waisted joggers, which are really cute. And then I just have on my new Uggs, which I showed you guys in my last vlog. But I'm now going to go and film. Once I've done this, I think I'm going to head back to Starbucks and edit in there, just to get out of the house, like I said this morning. And then I'm actually heading to Zelia's later on this evening. I'm not sure if we're going to have Mila to babysit anymore, because I think she's got a little cold, bless her. So I'm not really sure what the plans are, but either way I'm going to go over there and we're going to have a takeaway, a little bit of a catch up, probably play some games on Switch. Me and Ben are obsessed with our Switches, so that's probably what I'm going to be doing this evening. I have literally just finished filming. I just filmed in this like super cozy setup here. Like I'm so chilled out right now, I could probably have a nap, I'm not going to lie. It is I think around 1 o'clock, so it's still pretty early, like for me anyway. I'm kind of loving getting up early. I know some people literally get up at 6 a.m. every day out of choice. It's just not me. So I feel like, I don't know, I'm just getting so much done in a day. Like when I get up early, I'm like, oh my god, there is actually so many hours in a day. So I'm being very productive. I also love the fact that it means that I kind of switch off a bit at like 6 o'clock at like a normal time, because otherwise I'll be working until literally midnight. But yeah, I'm surrounded by mess. Like surrounded by mess. This is like a sneak peek of everything that I showed you guys in the video. So that I think should already, yeah, it will already be out by the time this vlog comes out, so I'll link it down below if you want to go and watch it. But my camera is flashing red, so my battery is about to die, so I'm going to pack up my stuff and head to Starbucks and get editing, so I want to get this video out tomorrow. So yeah. Okay, I'm in the car. I've put this gilet on because I always forget I have it, and it's like the comfiest thing in the world. But I just feel like I look like Boo in Monsters, Inc. when they try and disguise her. Do you know what I mean? Because she has like the big puffy jacket on and she's like walking around like this. Like I feel like that. Anyway, it's keeping me warm and I'm about to head to Starbucks. I've got my laptop and stuff in here, which is my Girl of Muse tote. This thing is a lifesaver. I literally, anywhere I go now, I can't go without a tote bag, which is a newfound thing for me, but it's very handy. I'm so snug right now. I'm really enjoying this. Filming went really well. I'm just in a really good mood. Like this is a future note to you, Emily, editing this. Get up earlier because you're just, I don't know, you're thriving. I feel like I have so many more hours in the day. Like obviously I know all these things are very obvious, but when I wake up late, I just work until later. Whereas I'm really loving this feeling of like, it's only 2 o'clock and I've got everything filmed. I can now go and sit and edit. Like I'm gonna take myself off to a coffee shop, which I never usually do. Like I don't do these things on my own, but I'm like, get out the house, like go and have some nice lunch on my own. I love doing things on my own, like, but I only really do it when I have to type thing. Like I really don't mind doing it, but I never do it out of choice. And I should, because I do enjoy it. So this is me going for lunch on my own out of choice. So yeah, I'm gonna grab myself some food, sit and edit this video. I want to get out tomorrow, I think I mentioned that to you guys. So a really quick turnaround, which is good, so I want to get back on my proper schedule. And then I think I will head home briefly, probably have a shower, get all freshened up, get this makeup off, get this hairspray out of my hair. My hair is so slick today, like it's unreal. I have so much product in it. So I think I'm gonna have a shower, get in a fresh tracksuit, and then head over to Ben and Zell's this evening. Then I'm probably gonna sleep at mum and dad's because Brad is away for the night. He's in London, because he was in the office today, and then he's in the office tomorrow. So I've got a night on my own, and I don't like sleeping on my own. So I'm probably gonna stay at mum and dad's, which is fine because it means I get to see the dogs and mum and dad, obviously. But I can have a catch up with them very briefly this evening when I get back. Anyway, I will probably see you guys at Starbucks. I don't know how much I'm gonna film because it will probably be quite busy, and I'm a little bit shy with the camera in public. So I will insert some snippets of what I got up to. Pitch black, as you can probably tell by the quality of this camera. I didn't finish editing. It's now 5:40. I'm about to head off to Ben and Zell's, but yeah, I got halfway through editing because, weirdly, considering I never like go to Starbucks on my own, like I never usually do that. I think I told you guys that earlier. Me and my mum have this really weird, almost like sixth sense thing. Like, she'll be thinking of something and then I'll message her and she'll message me back and be like, I was literally just thinking about you. Or I'll be thinking about something she did, or like I'll be talking to Brad about her or something like that, and then she'll message me. And sometimes it's been about like specific things that I've just mentioned and haven't spoken about for the rest of the day, if that makes sense. So we've always had this weird thing, and I never go to Starbucks on my own. Like, I think I mentioned earlier, I never do things like that. And it just so happened that my mum ended up being in town. And she wasn't meant to go to town today. Like, something happened yesterday that meant she had to go in today. And she also got to the car park, and the one space that there was right opposite my car. And if she hadn't have parked in that space, or if she hadn't have come into town, like, she never would have seen my car and wouldn't have even known I was there. So she called me, and I instantly knew. I was like, she's here, or I don't know. I just knew that she had this weird feeling that I was in Starbucks. So she called me and she was like, are you in Starbucks? And I was like, yeah. She was like, I can see your car. And I was like, yeah, I've literally come here for the first time in forever. Like, I've genuinely never sat in that Starbucks ever. And it was just so weird. So I was like, I'll just come in. Like, and we just had a bit of a catch up and a chat, which was really nice. I've got all day tomorrow to edit, so it's absolutely fine. I'm actually really happy with the video as well. It's like super chilled and chatty. Kind of love favourites videos, and I want to bring them back to my channel because they are really quite helpful, I find. Like, I love watching other people's. But anyway, I am now going to get on the road. I've sent Zell my live location, like I always do, so that is what I'm now off to do.
What do we do now?
Wait, so
Ben, what sides do you want?
Wait, get us some wedges. Bless you. You all right?
No.
Aww.
Does anyone want a big garlic dip?
Oh. Yeah. I feel like I want some sort of dip.
Big garlic.
Go on then. I'm allowed that, aren't I? Has it got egg?
Yeah.
Egg yolk? No, because there's some things I'm not allowed.
You're not allowed eggs?
You're not allowed egg yolks.
Oh.
No, you're not allowed raw egg yolks, and I don't know if that has it.
Can pregnant people eat garlic dip from Domino's?
I look ugly. Where's that from? No. It's what from, does anyone know where it's from? She doesn't say it like that, but she says ugly like that.
Is it not when it's like UGL?
No, it's from the movie, what's it called? You know where she like dressed up as a boy? Yeah, yeah, yeah!
I love she's the man.
Because you're ugly, or something like that.
The answer to the question was, okay then.
Oh, it's fine. I'm sure it'll be alright.
I'm sure it'll be fine. By the way, I'm at Zell's.
Oh, yeah.
Zell is here.
I'm in my Christmas pyjamas.
She's getting very festive. You know people put their trees up yesterday.
I know, that's a bit too soon for me.
Yeah, not gonna lie, that is a bit too soon.
I do have red nails though, because I thought festive as well.
Yeah, I really like them. Mm-hmm. But we're ordering Domino's. Because it's Tuesday. So we get two for Tuesday. Which, to be fair, yeah, look. So two medium pizzas would be £40.
I think Domino's is an absolute rip-off.
Same, but it's really yummy, so.
I mean.
Should we just get the chicken box?
Alright, do that then.
Wings, kickers,
yeah, go on then, why not? Might as well go
all out. Do you know what? It's Tuesday. Treat yourself. Yeah, we're on holidays. Pepperoni.
I've got ice cream in the cupboard, but I mean in the cupboard. I mean in the freezer, but if that's you want to get some.
It's probably a milkshake now.
You can get some if you want some.
No, I don't like ice cream.
You don't like
Don't.
I don't want to hear it.
You don't like
it? I don't want to hear it.
You don't like ice cream?
I never fancy it.
I don't really rate ice cream, to be honest.
No, yeah, I don't get when people are like, I love
ice cream. Do you know what I like? I love a 99.
I tell you what.
With Mr. Whippy,
which are now £1.50.
An ice, like an ice lolly is nice in the heat.
Nah, Mr. Bubble. Nice.
I thought I'd show you this. I picked this up in B&M the other day. It's one of the Bedhead products. This is the Bedhead Ego Boost Split End Mender Leave-In Conditioner. One, it smells incredible, but I am gonna slick my hair back again today. So I thought I'd just kind of scrunch this in my ends. And because it's a leave-in conditioner, hopefully it's gonna work its magic. I stayed over at Mum and Dad's last night and I've literally just come home, had a shower, and I'm now about to head back out, pick up Zal, and go for brunch. Me and Georgia were like, should we do brunch today? Georgia, my friend who lives up here, not Georgia May. I feel like there's so many people in my life that literally have the same names. Like, I know so many Emilys, so many Georgias, so many Mollys. I think that's about it, but it just gets very confusing when I'm talking about people. So yeah, we just messaged her this morning and was like, you up for brunch? And she is, so I'm gonna go and pick her up. Obviously I went to theirs last night, which is really nice. We literally just chilled, got a Domino's. I think I left around like 9:30, and then like I say, just stayed at Mum and Dad's, so I got to see the dogs and I got to see them this morning, which makes me so happy. And Mum and Dad are all good. They were watching some like random series about climate change or something. I don't know, apparently there was like a whole scandal that happened and they were watching a program about that, so I just edited. I'm really not one for series. I think I've said this before, but I just don't enjoy a series. I just watch YouTube. Like, YouTube is literally my life. That's all I do. Anyway, I am just getting myself ready. I am going to slick my hair back, like I say. I was going to put makeup on, but I just washed my face with my usual face wash. And for some reason, it's given me a rash. I don't know if you guys can see. Like, all up here, I've just got, like, raised bumps. So I'm not really sure whether to actually put makeup on today. So I think I might just slick my hair and be done. I am just wearing this Essentials hoodie, which honestly I feel like it's seen better days. I've kind of worn this to death, I'm not gonna lie. But then I've got on these Zara trousers, which are my new favorite things. These are in a large, is the only thing I would say. So if you do like the look of them, size up, because I mean, these barely fit me. Like, I'm gonna keep it real with you guys. There is a zip at the side here. By the way, this is bloat. And just my stomach, really. No excuse, it's just what I look like. I just don't really want the usual comments of, oh my God, are you pregnant? Like, no, this is just what I look like. So anyway, they do up with a zip at the side here. And she's holding on, I'm not gonna lie. So, like I said, if you do like the look of them, definitely size up. But they are quite possibly my favorite thing. They go all the way down. They have like this split hem with a zip, so you can kind of split them as much as you want. And then I've got my tracks on, which are way too small for me, as we know, but they look cute, this outfit. Very simple, but we are literally just going for brunch, so I wanted to be comfy. Anyway, I am in a little bit of a rush, so I'm gonna finish getting ready. Like I said, I just wanted to show you guys this because I'm actually really happy with it. It smells incredible as well. Like, it makes your hair smell nice too. So yeah, see you in a sec.
My hair is back in its usual style and I'm about to head out, but I thought I'd just quickly show you what my outfit looks like in a full length mirror, because I just watched those clips back and you literally can't see what I'm talking about. But this is the hoodie from Kit Game, which is a reseller, but that's where I get all my essentials jumpers from, even my knitted one, which I sometimes get questions on. I then got my little Louis bag, my little wallet on chain, and these are the trousers that I was talking about. So they're super high-waisted, love the style of them. They're just like a straight leg. And then I've literally just got on my Balenciaga tracks.
Oh my God, it's actually freezing today. I just quickly ran in and grabbed my coat as well, because I don't know what's happening to the weather, but it's very cold. I thought I'd just, oh God, quickly sit in the car and do a little bit of makeup. I'm not going to put too much on, like I'm not going to put foundation on or anything, because my skin is dying down, but I just don't really understand what happened. I keep meaning to recharge my Vireo. I used to always use the Luna Mini 2 and it's run out of charge, and it ran out of charge like literally ages ago, you know, when you just keep forgetting to do things. But I actually really rate it, like I use it all the time. And I find it's the best thing that works for me and doesn't like break me out or anything or like irritate my skin. I'm so, so lucky on my skin. I feel like I say this all the time, but touch wood, I'm very lucky that I don't suffer with like spots or anything like that. Like, I just sometimes react to random things, which is kind of annoying when I'm trying to figure out exactly what it is. But like just now, I think I basically used some exfoliating gloves and I don't think that was the best thing to do. And my skin is probably just like, what are you doing? Do you know what I mean? I think I might try and upgrade my phone today. Kind of want the new iPhone. But then I did see Sid the other day. She said don't even bother upgrading it if you want it for the camera, because apparently it's not that much better. And that is pretty much the only reason I only ever upgrade my phones, is because the camera's better. So maybe I'll think about it. Right, I'm just gonna do a minimal amount of makeup and then I'm sure I'll pick you guys back up when I've picked up Zoe. I'm gonna go pick up her and then we're gonna go meet George in the city. She's currently buying a house, so I think she needs to like put a load of papers in somewhere. I don't know. Oh, we're back with the Hi. Car park vlogs. I feel like
yeah, it's a little segment thing now.
Mm-hmm. Just picked up Zoe.
Hello.
We're actually running really late, so if
we are,
I was gonna say if Georgia watches this, but she doesn't watch YouTube, so she's never gonna know.
That's true.
You look really small again.
It's because I'm so sure.
Maybe I'll just...
Do you tell them where we're going tomorrow?
We're going to see JLS.
Going to see JLS?
I still haven't... I actually think I said it at the start of the vlog and I was like, I'm going to listen to that album on repeat.
Oh, well, we'll listen to it on the way.
I haven't listened to it once.
We'll listen to it on the way and get ourselves in the mood and it'll be great.
Were you like a diehard fan?
I was a big fan, yeah. I know all their songs.
Really?
Mm-hmm. I was an Aston fan. I think Ash was a Marvin, yeah. They're good. I'm excited.
I like Marvin and Michelle.
Yeah, I do. I loved the Saturdays as well, and they were around the same sort of time. So.
Oh, to be back in them days when they were a thing.
I know.
We were so young. I've started to feel very old recently, I'm not going to lie.
Oh, if you feel old, how do you think I feel? I'm really old then. I'm 26. Oh my God.
You know someone in the last video said that you look about 15?
Oh, it's a thing. I'll take that as a compliment.
That's a great compliment.
That is a great, thank you very much, whoever said that. I appreciate that. I think it's 26.
Yeah, because I said you're having a baby and I think someone was like, sorry,
she's not in school. Yeah, no, I'm 26. I always get told I look younger. I feel younger, but I'm closer to 30 than I am 20. That is literally insane.
Because I just don't feel that about you.
No, but you're not that much younger than me. It's
well,
just
I'm
like,
I'm closer
like
to
20 years?
Than I am to 30.
Yeah, how old are you? You're 24, okay.
Yeah. Brad's 25, he's like over the horizon.
Yeah. That's how I felt last year. I'm going to be 27 next year.
Well, at least you'll look maybe 18 when you're 30.
Yeah, like when I'm 40, I'm going to look 30, so it's fine.
Right, let's get some food.
Question from the last vlog. Have you used your stuff we got from Bedhead?
Yeah.
And what do you think?
Loved it. The leave-in conditioner.
Yeah, I used the... Oh, you didn't buy it, but I used the purple one.
Yeah.
That's really good.
I think I did buy that. I didn't buy the yellow one.
It smells incredible.
Really?
Yeah, use it if you haven't. But that made my hair feel really soft, and like I used it and blow dried my hair and it didn't have no flyaways, nothing. It was really nice.
Nice.
Yeah, let's go.
The leave-in conditioner is nice. Like, I put it in the ends today.
Which one was that one? I haven't used that yet.
The pink with the green lid.
Oh, I'll have to use that.
Meh.
Right,
quick. Thought we'd do outfits, but we're in the list and we have 2 seconds. Pretty Little Thing, Kit Game, Zara, Balenciaga. I've pressed a button.
All Neutrals, Primark. I don't know where they're from.
Pretty Little Thing, aren't they?
These are from I Saw It First.
Oh, it's a lot of salmon. And we're back.
We're upside down.
No, we're not.
We are.
I flip it in my editing skills.
We are upside down.
Oh, what do you think? We were chatting for like 3 hours?
Yep.
4 hours?
According to the car park.
Yeah, true. We got some carrot cake, which I'm actually so excited about it. We went to...
Number 33.
Yeah, so if you're in Norwich, highly recommend. The food is actually great.
Mm-hmm. It's very like brunch vibes, like breakfast and stuff like that.
All day brunch.
Mm-hmm.
Well, this smells incredible. You didn't get any, did you?
Just wasn't feeling it.
I feel like I'm going to tip this and it's going to fall out into the car.
Look, honestly, it's so creamy and just so delicious. Full of flavour.
Mm-hmm. What's your name? What's that guy that's on MasterChef? The guy that tastes the food? Greg something, the bald guy?
I don't know.
You really remind me of him, actually.
Me?
Yeah.
The bald one?
Yeah.
Why?
Because he's bald.
Am I bald?
I'm kidding. Everyone takes our home. And then we both have some work to do, don't we?
Yes.
We could have done it together. I really should have bought my laptop.
You should have. I don't know why you didn't. I'm going to be home alone now all day. You probably know anyway.
I am going to be home alone as well.
What time is Brad back?
I don't know. I haven't heard from him.
Ben's not going to be back till like freaking 8:30, 9.
Why?
I told you. Weren't you listening to our combo?
He's getting a haircut.
Yeah. So he's going to go straight to his after work. And obviously we don't know what time he's going to be finishing.
I haven't heard from Brad. So no idea. Could be anywhere. Well, I know he's in London, but... I don't know what time he's coming home. I'm going to actually be really annoyed if I hear from him and he's like, can you pick me up from the station? And I'd be like, just got home.
Maybe you should contact him while you're in Norwich.
Yeah, well, I'll call him. This car park actually stresses me out. Like, it gives me anxiety. Because, like, am I meant to go or is she meant to go? Where's my ticket?
Did you put it in here?
I hope so. I can't remember. I'm actually hoping it's in
here. No, we've got a tampon. We've got some tablets.
Honey, I mean, you're going the wrong way.
No, it's not in here.
Are you kidding me? That.
Oh wait, is it this?
Or is it this?
No, it's not that one.
Yeah,
is it this
that one?
One?
Yeah. Thank you.
Ooh.
He's parking.
Be patient. That's Mimi. Or is that George?
Why are you shaking your head? She's parking.
Oh, he's literally shaking his head.
Oh, he's gonna get really annoyed
yeah.
now.
Can he see you looking at him?
Yeah.
Just smile.
I am.
Yeah, make him feel frustrated.
Love you, bestie.
Yeah. What so rude, like, just
hate
let
people like
park.
Life's too short to be rude, like, stop being rude.
We're gonna moan at someone because they're taking too long to park. Jesus Christ.
Look, obviously, he's like an absolute saint. He does everything right in his life. Like, he's almighty.
Do you know what I mean?
We're all going really slow, but he is very close to, like,
he's in my boot. He's literally in my boot.
He's so close to me.
I'm not the problem here, mate. You're the problem. And you have a problem. Who beats someone in a car park? Like,
hello?
Oh, he's scary. I actually
he's going to go next to you, isn't he? It's good. It's fine. We're not scared of you.
Oh, he wanted to get out before me.
Oh, go on, go on, go, go on. Look at him like revving. Oh, calm down, mate.
Oh, at least he'll have a better day now he's being rude to people. Because obviously that's what being rude to people does. It makes you have a better day, doesn't it? Not. I can't believe I've never eaten there. And it's like the only place where I hear everybody speak about it. And you know, like, people always ask me where to go in Norwich, and I'm like, I don't know.
I would recommend there, yeah. I would say that pancakes are really good in there.
Yeah, do you know what? We should have shared some pancakes in the middle. Just have a little bite.
We do that sometimes. Whoever I go with.
I love pancakes.
Me too. But I'm just into biscuits at the moment.
Tea and biscuits.
So I just, yeah. Or milk and cookies.
Do you think that's your only craving at the moment?
Do you know what? It's weird because I haven't really got any cravings. I just know what I don't want.
Yeah. That's like the other end of it, isn't it? It's like you really go off things and then you really crave things.
Yeah, I was saying to Emily, like, my perfume taste has changed. And I like Britney Spears' hair.
Am I meant to be going down here?
This is why she's laughing. Yeah. I used to love that growing up. And I always had it in my drawer. And I sprayed it. And Aisha, I said to Aisha, I was like, I swear you used to use this. She said I wore it when I was pregnant.
Oh my god, no way.
Now I am.
That's so funny. Okay. I really like that about you.
What?
If you want to know something about someone, you literally just ask them. Like when we were in Mallorca, and we all sat there, like, because there were so many English people like working there. And yeah. Every single person, she was like, I wonder what made them come out here. Like, I wonder why they work here. And we'd be like, yeah, like, I wonder. And
then they say Gemini's are nosy.
True. They come to get the drinks and Del will be like, what made you come and work out here?
Yeah, I didn't say it like that. I just want to ask you a question.
It's like, so funny.
Because when you think about it, like, you know, a British person moving to a foreign country. Like, I moved to a foreign country for a year and it's quite fascinating. So I like to ask, you know, why other people have. And a lot of them just say they just come to work and just to get out of England.
Yeah, get out of the country. I just love how you ask because I'm like, I really want to know, but I know I'm not going to ask. And then... I love knowing things. Yeah.
I don't remember a lot of it, but I love knowing things.
Made it home. I am literally just procrastinating because it is chucking it down outside. It probably doesn't sound as bad as it is, but I don't really want to get out and get soaking wet, even though my front door is literally like, it's there. It's two steps away. But I feel like I'm just going to get soaked. So I thought I'd just sit here for a sec, wait for the rain to pass. It was so nice to get out today. I just feel really, really lucky that I can do things like that. Like, sometimes I think it's very easy to take anything in your life for granted. And something I will never take for granted is being able to just do anything I want whenever I want. Like, I find that insane. Like, I still have moments where I'm like, wow, this really is my life. And I feel very lucky to be able to go and see my friends and, like, catch up with people and be on my own schedule and stuff. Don't get me wrong, obviously I've come back now and I have literally so much work to do, but that's fine. Like, I love the fact that I can just kind of do everything after and just balance my life really easily. So yeah, just having a bit of a grateful moment, I guess. I am gonna go inside now and set the favorites video live. So like I mentioned earlier, if you haven't watched that already, it will already be live on my channel, so I'm going to link it in the description if you do want to go and see it. This coat, by the way, I did link this in a recent vlog. It's from Pretty Little Thing. I basically saw it on Money Mail a little while ago and I was like, I need that in my life. Only thing I would say is I think I got it a little bit too big because it's just very like baggy on the shoulders. So I can't remember exactly what size I got this in, but I believe I sized up like twice. So maybe size up just once, or if not, stick to your normal size. And I think it's like an oversized fit anyway. But it's really cute. It's like this kind of, almost like velvety material, I would say. But definitely not velvet. Like, it just feels really soft. It's like a bomber style. Very cute for this time of year. But yeah, I think I just need to suck it up and go in. Said he needs to crack on with work. Brad has just phoned me and he is getting the 3 o'clock train home. So he will actually be home or like back at the station in literally half an hour. Well, I'd have to leave here in half an hour to then pick him up at 5. So as much as I feel really bad doing this, I do have a lot to do and he did offer, but he is gonna get a taxi home because it just works so much better for me. And it means that he'll get home a lot quicker because it's also rush hour and God knows what. So he's gonna get a taxi home because it massively helps me out. It means I can just go and crack on. Really? Just as I go to leave the car, it gets heavier? Wow. I actually don't feel that bad though, because the carrot cake that I showed you guys earlier, I did actually get him a slice as well. So I hope that kind of makes up for it. Anyway, I'm going to stop procrastinating and go and crack on. When I say I was out there for 2.5 seconds, love that for me. One thing I actually do love is how cozy it feels coming home when it is like chucking it down outside. I love coming into a cozy warm house. That is actually one thing that I kind of don't mind about it getting so dark so quickly. Just feels very cozy inside. I think I'm going to put the fire on and sit in the lounge and do my editing. I'm back in the car again. It's like I literally slept here and we're back. I didn't.
When did you film today? Have you filmed?
I haven't, no.
Oh.
And I've got no battery. Anyway.
Do you want to borrow more? Oh, we ain't got the same camera. I have a fully charged Canon. You really? Should have told me. Canon battery.
I didn't realise until I've just turned it on. We're on our way to London. I will have to do the rest of this vlog on my phone, which is really annoying.
Silly
but
Billy.
I'm sure it'll be fine.
I come prepared. I have two, and then Aisha also has some jars.
Really?
Yeah.
We've just stopped off at Starbucks to grab some food. The Christmas cups are back. This makes me so happy.
Look how cute the Christmas cups are.
Such an anti-climax when you get a cold drink at Christmas. But I was kind of hoping it was going to be just fully red. Not going to lie.
No, I kind of like that. Like, if you look at it from there, it looks like wrapping paper.
We're on the phone. Only thing with vlogging on the phone is I always look over here and you're meant to look over there.
Yeah.
Anyway, happy the Christmas cats are back. We are on our way to pick up Aish. And then
we're going to be late.
To London. We are going to be late. But it's fine. I'm meeting my manager for lunch. You're meeting your manager for lunch.
Mm-hmm.
So we're having a productive day, but also we're just going for fun and then.
Yeah.
We're actually heading back this evening.
JLS. Which Emily's so excited about.
I am excited because I love a concert. I love like seeing loads of people happy in a room. I just love that. Like everyone's in a good mood when you're at a concert.
I feel like it's just, yeah. Like everyone's happy.
I've never looked around and seen someone like at a concert, do you know what I mean? So
I love it.
I'm excited for that. I just don't know the songs. So we need to actually play something.
We're listening to them on the way.
Actually, I say that. I was annoying Brad until about 1 a.m. singing Everybody in Love. And he was like, please don't practice now. I was like, okay. He was getting very annoyed.
I'm getting ready.
Yeah, but I was trying.
There we go. Sorry.
It's fine. Oh my God, that girl's car is so
filthy.
Dirty.
It is, isn't it?
Only one side. What has happened?
Oh, she might have got splashed.
It's black.
She probably got splashed on one side.
Her car looks black, but it's silver.
Why is my camera on a wonk?
I don't know. Yeah, it really is. You need to tighten it a bit more.
Yeah, but then if I tighten it, I can't.
You're flipped around the wrong way. Right, I need to help this girl up.
Sorry.
I will probably update you guys when we get there, or when we get Aish actually.
Is here.
I'm probably shaking because I am so cold right now.
I think because I'm like excited.
Do you know what it is? You've gone for the practical outfit that actually keeps you warm.
I've got joggers on.
To be fair. The coldest part of me right now is my forehead, and I can't figure out if it's because she put something like this serum on my face. By the way, this is my makeup.
It looks so good.
It was weird to get your makeup done. Like, it was very impulsive, like so unnecessary, I'm not gonna lie, but really thoroughly enjoyed it.
It's really relaxing.
Wasn't it?
I felt like I was gonna fall asleep.
Yeah, I felt like that. Yeah, she used like this serum, and I honestly think it's like frozen my forehead. My forehead just here, like just the top, is so cold.
Looking at both of you, honestly, whatever she's putting on,
yeah.
It looks so good.
Oh, I bought
serum. I bought serum.
I want to know you, but I don't know how. Cause every time I bump right into you, I get all tongue-tied. Want you to know me, but I'm way too shy. I can't just go around admitting that it's you I like. I wish that I had guts enough to flirt a little, but I'm too scared I'll fail.
Hi guys, it is quite a few days later, I'm not gonna lie. I did just want to jump on the end of this vlog to kind of round it off. I know it was a little bit of a random week, but I'm excited to bring these weekly vlogs back because I just really like filming them and I love editing them and kind of looking back at what I've been up to. So I hope you guys really enjoyed watching it. I know this kind of ended on a Thursday, so it wasn't technically a whole weekly vlog, but obviously you guys saw that we went to the JLS concert, which was actually so fun. Friday, I literally just had a day on my laptop all day, like that's all I did. And then this weekend, we had quite a busy Saturday actually. We went up to the city, went for brunch. If you guys follow me on Instagram, you probably saw what we got up to. But we did a little bit of home shopping because, like I kind of briefly mentioned, we are like wanting to basically sort the house out as it is now. So if you guys have been keeping up with like the moving vlog side of things, you'll probably know that we spoke about like extending this house and like completely renovating it and like adding a whole new room and switching the kitchen and the lounge around, like all these crazy things that we were gonna do, which I would love to do, but it's like I said earlier in this vlog, it's not a necessity, and it's just meant that we've put like everything on hold in regards to the house. Like, we've not made anything really feel like our own or really feel like home because we've almost just been waiting to do that big project. So we've kind of sat down, thought about it, thought about how much money it's going to cost, being kind of realistic with finances, like is it going to add that much value to the house? Like, it could literally be, and I'm kind of saying this overestimating everything because you always want to do that when it comes to building work because you just never know, but it could be like £80,000 worth of work. Like, it could be insane. And yes, like, it would make the home incredible and like everything we've ever wanted, but there is a ceiling price to houses, and sometimes you do just have to think about finances and boring things like that and being adults. So we've kind of done that and just decided that we have more than enough space in this house as it is. Like, we are very, very lucky to live here, and for the price that we got this house and everything like that, we are really lucky with the space that we have. So we are going to focus on making it much more homely. I'm going to be able to finally cook in the kitchen and not say to you guys, sorry about the mess in the background, you guys know how much I hate this kitchen. That's going to be gone soon because we did actually go into Wren Kitchens on Saturday, and I actually met one of you guys, which was so surreal and so nice. She was literally the loveliest girl ever. I believe her name was Sophie. So if you're ever in the Wren Kitchens, which is like Sproston way, like Mousehold, make sure you ask for Sophie because she was very, very sweet, and she is now helping us design our kitchen. Yeah, that's what we did on Saturday. Sunday was super chilled because Saturday evening we went to Brad's parents and basically just drank a little bit too much. So Sunday was very chilled. I went to the driving range with the boys, and then we went for Nando's, and that was it really. Brad is currently in Amsterdam as I'm filming this bit, so it's currently Monday, hopefully when you guys are seeing this video. So I've got a couple of days just at the house. My friend's coming over this evening. I suppose I'm gonna have a little bit of a repeat of the week that I just had that you guys just saw, because I've got a lot of filming to do and things like that. So yeah, that is just a little bit of information to kind of fill you in on what I did for the rest of the week. Sorry about this angle, by the way, I'm literally standing in a really weird spot. I actually love this area of the house, and I never come and sit in here because I've currently got my sofa in here that was from the office. So this is like the pink L-shaped sofa. As you can see, I have covered it in throws, so it kind of suits this room a little bit better. But this area always has so much sun in it, which is really lovely.
So yeah, hopefully at some point soon this will be a nice breakfast bar. Hopefully. I am excited though to kind of get that process going, because obviously I can document it for you guys and talk you through all of our plans. But yeah, I hope you're all good. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please do give it a thumbs up if you did. Make sure you hit subscribe if you want to stick around for more in the future. I am going to go and have a shower and wash this absolute mess of a hairstyle. So I will leave you guys to it, and hopefully I'll speak to you very soon in my next video. Bye guys.